Finally, a topic that I know all about. So now imagine this. It's April 10, and you're on the R.M.S. Titanic, one of the largest and most luxurious ocean liners ever built, ready to depart from Southampton, England on its maiden voyage across the Atlantic Ocean. On April 10th, to great fanfare, the Royal Mail Ship Titanic sets sail on her fateful journey. The story's been told in print, in film, and has come to put a measure of the end of the era of optimism for its time. The R.M.S. Titanic left port as a ship of dreams. Only a few short days later, that journey turned into a horrible nightmare. The R.M.S. Titanic was a White Star Line passenger liner. The ship sank in the northern Atlantic Ocean in the early morning hours of April 15, 1912. The story of the Titanic ramming an iceberg during her maiden voyage is well known. The sinking has been documented in film, movies, stories, and still, after 100 years, the epic story still captures millions. The Titanic was bound from Southampton, UK to New York City, US. The sinking resulted in the loss of more than 1,500 passengers and crew, making it one of the deadliest commercial peacetime maritime disasters in modern history. The RMS Titanic was the largest ship afloat at the time it entered service. It was the second of three Olympic-class ocean liners operated by the White Star Line. The ships were built by the Harland and Wolff Shipyard in Belfast. Thomas Andrews, who was the ship's naval architect, was also among those lost in the sinking. On her maiden voyage, she carried 2,224 passengers and crew. The Titanic was under the command of Captain Edward Smith, one of White Star Line's most experienced sailors. The passengers list read like a who's who of people in the first class cabins. As well, there were hundreds of immigrants from Great Britain, Ireland, Scandinavia, and elsewhere throughout Europe seeking a new life in North America. A wireless telegraph was provided for the convenience of passengers as well for operational use. And although the Titanic had advanced safety features such as watertight compartments and remotely activated watertight doors, there were not enough lifeboats to accommodate all of those aboard due to outdated maritime safety regulations. The Titanic only carried enough lifeboats for 1,178 people, slightly more than half of the number on board and one-third her total capacity. After leaving Southampton on April 10, 1912, the Titanic docked in at Cherbourg, France, in Queenston, Ireland, before heading west. On April 14, 1912, 4 days into the crossing and about 375 miles south of Newfoundland, she hit an iceberg at 11:40 p.m. ship's time. The collision caused the ship's hull plates to buckle inwards along her starboard side and opened 5 of her 16 watertight compartments to the sea and gradually filling with water. Meanwhile, passengers and some crew members were evacuated in lifeboats, many of which were launched, only partly loaded. A disproportionate number of men were left aboard because of a women and children only protocol, followed by some of the officers loading the lifeboats. By 2:20 a.m., she broke apart and foundered, with well over 1,000 people still aboard. And just under 2 hours after, the Cunard liner RMS Carpathia arrived on the scene of the sinking, where she brought aboard an estimated 705 survivors. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's video. I had actually planned for another one to come up this week that was related to New York, but instead, this one came out because I realized what the date was, and I had to. So, next week's video will be also related to New York, but that's all I'm going to say about it. Anyway, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in next week's video.